While the Food and Drug Administration on Monday issued full approval for the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine, America's Delta-driven surge of COVID-19 has entered a deadlier phase. Cases are rising in 42 states, the lowest such number in 6 weeks. But deaths are now increasing in 43 states, the worst tally since December, before America's deadliest month of the pandemic, a USA Today analysis of Johns Hopkins University data shows. U.S. deaths in the week ending Monday totaled 7,225. By comparison, about 5,400 Americans died in the Pearl Harbor and 9/11 attacks combined. The face of who is dying is also changing quickly. Deaths are increasingly centered among white non-Hispanic people, a USA Today analysis of National Centers for Health Statistics data shows. Most other racial and ethnic groups now have a smaller share of deaths, but white non-Hispanics, which represent about 61.1% of all deaths during the pandemic, made up 68.8% of the deaths reported so far in July and August. Meanwhile, the share of deaths among young people is jumping, too. Those in their 30s and people 18 to 29 have roughly tripled their share of deaths in July and August, preliminary Centers for Disease Control and Prevention tallies show. People in their 50s and early 60s have represented fewer than one of every six victims in the pandemic, but in July and August they make up more than one of every four. Massachusetts will require all school teachers and students in grades K-12 to wear masks through at least October 1. Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmidt filed a class action lawsuit Tuesday trying to stop school districts from enforcing mask mandates, citing the low death rate from COVID-19 among school-aged children. For information on vaccine and mask mandates in every state, click here. Starting Friday, Oregon will require masks to be worn in most public outdoor settings where physical distancing is not possible, regardless of vaccination status. LSU, ranked 13th in the USA Today College Football Coaches Preseason Poll, said Tuesday that fans 12 and older attending home games this season will have to present proof of vaccination against COVID-19 or a negative test. Florida's Walt Disney World will require its workers to be fully vaccinated against COVID-19 to keep their jobs at the theme park, starting October 22. Keep refreshing this page for the latest news. Want more? Sign up for USA Today's Coronavirus Watch newsletter to receive updates directly to your inbox and join our Facebook group. There's growing evidence about the need for COVID-19 vaccine booster shots, possibly sooner than later. A CDC study released Tuesday shows protection from the vaccines may decline over time as the wildly contagious Delta variant surges across the country. Once Delta became the dominant strain in the U.S., vaccine effectiveness against infection decreased from 91% to 66%.